Feeling rough. I feel quite rough today. Tired, headachy. I drank and smoked too much last night. That last Guinness and cigarette tipped me over the edge. Or was it the one before that? I don't feel that unhappy, but there must be a certain level of dissatisfaction and loneliness. Ironically, I seem to sabotage my own strong desire to be creative by rendering my mind and body incapable of doing so. So, I've resorted to words, as music seems too difficult today, and the results could be disappointing, assuming I'm capable of producing anything. I say resorted to words as if there is something easy about writing, as if it's easier to say something in the English language than through music, as if anyone would be remotely interested in my little bouts of self-loathing and middle-class struggle for expression. Even the act of writing about one's self feels like a plea for attention. Still, you are who you are, better out than in, and other useful platitudes. What damage could I possibly do to my, open quotes, social standing, close quotes? Perhaps the most freeing aspect of all is that ultimately, it doesn't really matter. Have conviction, believe in yourself, send it out there, so that a handful of people may momentarily stop what they're doing and think, I'm not sure about this, but it seemed to strike a chord with me. Or, what are they on? Or, who the hell do they think they are? Human endeavours that somehow relate to our innermost hopes and fears. Things we don't generally discuss. Things that are a little uncomfortable. That's where I position myself, just below the surface. Of course, the very act of personal declaration and wringing of hands and clutching at head, oh woe is me and my artistic struggle, doesn't sit too well in my book. However, if you don't empathise with yourself, how can you empathise with others? If there is a reason for art at all, then surely it must be to communicate emotions to others. So people go, yes, I feel that too. It's very easy to be defined by what you do for a living. Yes, that's in quotes too. No more so for an artist of any persuasion. The output is you. So if you don't like a piece of art, how do you avoid having negative feelings for the perpetrator? No self-pity, no self-aggrandisement, no pretense. Sometimes it's enough to just do. And so I present to you, this is what I did today, whilst feeling rough. A known piece of writing in any idiom. It just is.